Welcome to This Is My Architecture. My name is Andrea, and I'm here with Manish from Amagi. Hi, Manish. Welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
So what do you guys do?
Amagi provides cloud playout services for TV networks and content owners. We help them manage and distribute the linear channels.
Awesome. So we're going to talk about linear broadcast. What is that?
So linear broadcast is a combination of services mm-hmm. that allows content owners to have a channel out of VOD and live events.
Oh, very nice. So this resides on AWS, as we see, use a number of different AWS services. So walk us through a scenario. What would be defined as an event?
An event could be a sporting event, or a news broadcast, or a cooking show.
Okay, let's take the sporting events as an example. So what's the first thing that happens?
In a sporting event, there's traditionally a venue, which resides here. And in that venue, there's generally cameras.
Okay, so what do you then do with the content generated from that sporting event?
So that feed goes into Cloudport Live.
I see. Is that a streaming event?
So that's usually a 60 feed SRT or a direct connect feed that comes into Amagi.
Okay, so you have it in Cloudport Live, which I see is a Kubernetes cluster. What happens next?
In that, we usually have an automation system that's involved that is responsible for scheduling.
I see. So you schedule the events, and that also resides on a cluster of EC2s. Is that correct?
Correct.
So walk us through the next step. You schedule it. It's supposed to be broadcast, you know, next day. What happens?
So in this case, the automation service is responsible for scheduling that asset. In this case, it's a live event. So the automation service speaks to our cloud playout, which is responsible for playing out the event, which is to be broadcasted tomorrow in this case.
Okay.
And that cloud playout will get that feed from Cloudport Live.
I see. So this seems very CPU intensive. Tell me more about the clusters. What instance types do you use?
So based on the workloads, depending on the content that's coming in, either a HD or a 4K feed, we scale up the infrastructure based on what's required for that resource.
Okay. And is that GPU-based instances? I suspect it's heavy processing here.
So in this case, Amagi leverages no GPU environment. So we have all infrastructure running on EC2s and CPU-only based computing.
Okay. So you have then live events coming in. I see an S3 bucket. What kind of content do you store in S3?
So on an S3 bucket, there's a number of assets that are stored, one of them being a VOD file. We also have closed captioning, and we also have graphics that are available for assets.
I see. So how do you schedule that? How does that combine then to the live stream data that comes in?
So in the case for graphics, for example, the Amagi's asset processing engine kicks in. In this case, a graphics may be required. A ticker or a lower third might be required in a live event. In this case, the asset processing engine kicks in based on the automation schedule and applies that graphic to the playout.
Okay, so graphic and the playout, then what happens next?
In this case, after the graphic's been scheduled, the playout engine sends the information down to the hitless switcher.
Okay, and walk us through the function. What does hitless switchers do?
In this case, Amagi's hitless switcher is responsible for switching between feeds in the cases of disaster recovery. In our case, there's traditionally a separate environment that we have in a different AZ. So in this case, we have a separate AZ, and the hitless switcher provides a butterfly. In this case, sends it to, in this case, another hitless switcher. And in this case, the content is sent here.
So let's walk through the scenario. I suspect that, you know, this has to be highly available. How do you ensure that? So you mentioned you have another switch. How do you maintain both instances and make sure that they are available at all times?
Yeah, so in this case, we have a parallel environment running in a different AZ.
Interesting.
So it's completely duplicated to provide the highest resiliency for broadcast-grade quality.
Okay, so it's almost like active-active. How do you then reach out to the broadcasters?
So in this case, the hitless switcher from this side we'll send it to the direct connect here, and then directly to the head end.
Interesting. So this seems to be high scale. Walk us through, how many channels do you support?
Amagi today powers over 400 channels, and at any given point, we're running over 1,000 different cores.
1,000 different cores, wonderful. This is very unique architecture, Manish. You know, doing linear broadcast at scale using AWS services. Thank you so much for walking us through this amazing architecture. And thank you for watching. This is my architecture.